So now I moved to Hong Kong. So I explained my experience in Hong Kong. I joined the Prison West Hospital in Hong Kong since the last February. However, everything is different from Japan. Two differences. Because family want to cross cramp air, the cramp strength is very important. So I check strength using my finger, and I check all instruments by myself. For example, material is also different. In Kawasaki Heritage Center, we use Asprex as strings. So Asprex is polyvinylidene difluoride. So it's different from just poly. So, but we can use only poly. And graft is different. So we can use only a jelly or hemashield. But in Kawasaki, we use in all cases Toriplex by Teru. Actually, Toriplex is a very good graft, but Fraflex, Jerry and Hemashield is very fragile in my field. And the environment is also different, because in Kawasaki Heritage Center, cardiopulmonary bypass is placed right side, generally left side. But in Hong Kong, cardiopulmonary bypass is placed left side and head side. Opposite direction. So preparation was required. However, the day had come suddenly. My first case was in PWH the 13th of February, last February. This is 26-year-old man and Marfan syndrome patient. An acute type B dissection, ruptured descending. And this diameter is very small, around 20 millimeter or something. So it is impossible to be treated by TEVR. This is a sagittal image of this patient. So just do it with only available material. Exposure is also different from my familiar. I couldn't use the left heart bypass because my perfusionist in Hong Kong is not familiar with the left heart bypass. Graft was also different. But anyway, I aim safely, certainly, because of this donation, this principle is making me possible to do this kind of operation. Okay, this patient has an 8-month baby, so I want to rescue him with my all best, all of my best. This is a completion photo of him, and this is a post-operative CT scan. Here it is completely and he discharged to his home 40 days later. So, but however, sharing the image of surgery is very important, because in Hong Kong, there are less experience of left heart surgery or left heart bypass. So I always draw this kind of drawing before surgery. So and I share my opinion with my colleagues. But in Hong Kong, we cannot organize a whole team meeting. So I'm now using this kind of WhatsApp. WhatsApp is similar with a LINE application, and I have some groups of complex aortic surgery group, and I send this is my some kind of my plan before surgery. So this group include not only surgeon but also perfusionist, anesthetist, and OT nurse. So they ask me something. So do you need a bilateral arterial line or some fat temperature is necessary for surgery rest? So even before surgery, we can share the image. So this is Crawford Extend 2 repair in Hong Kong. This is preoperative CT scan, and this patient was also Marfan syndrome patient. So chronic type A dissection patient underwent a ventral procedure, emergent ventral procedure 2 or 3 years ago, and he developed this aneurysm, supra-abdominal aortic aneurysm. This is surgical image. So again, I draw this kind of diagram before surgery and how to press the patient, what kind of retractor I want to use, and this is a sequence of my anastomosis. So they can image of my surgery, and this is actual surgery photo. So sorry, in Hong Kong we don't have a general video recording system, so just combined photo. This is exposure and exposed all aneurysm. So retractor is completely different. I use the femoral bypass. And proximal was clamped and opened up. So to occlude the intercostal artery backflow, I cannot use a shield which used in Kawasaki. So I changed to 3 French Fogarty and occlude intercostal artery backflow. And in Kawasaki, we can use 60 cm 4-branch graft for supra-abdominal aortic surgery, but it's not available in Hong Kong. So I combined 2 grafts. This patient has 186 cm height, as a very tall patient. And reconstruct the visceral vessels one by one. This method is the same with Kawasaki style. This is the actual completion photo of the supra-abdominal crop extended surgery. And this is my actual OT record. In total, I did 10 anastomoses. But fortunately, a patient could discharge to his home on foot. And this is also pretty CT scan. Intercostal artery was well reconstructed. All visceral vessels is impaired. For now, he has no he has no necessity of further intervention. The post-operative rehabilitation was also important. It's also important. This is one case presentation: 65-year-old female and post-renal transplantation and type A dissection with aortic root aneurysm. Emergent hemorrhage and ventral operation was done. And this is post-operative. 3 days after operation. She was intubated 3 days, but for the early patient recovery, I think mobilization is most important. So I asked ICU colleagues, this or ICU nurses, but they supported me. And it looks strange, but finally the patient could sit up at the bedside. This is me. I'm doing. So everything looks different, except for just one thing. Do our best for the patient. So what I have learned in Hong Kong, true difference doesn't matter. Material difference doesn't matter. Environmental difference doesn't matter. sharing spirit does matter. So this spirit has been shared with my Thai colleagues. So a lot of Thai colleagues visited Kawasaki Erotic Center. Now I'm sharing this spirit with Hong Kong colleagues. And now center, in this center photo, she is one of my junior in Hong Kong. Now she is studying Kawasaki aortic surgery, and she has already completed several cases, type A dissection and descending aortic surgery. This is a descending aortic replacement done by her. Prior continuous suture and whole circumference reinforcement suture. And this is making the air in the hole. Actually, this patient didn't need any additional stitch. So now there are a lot of innovative devices, but sharing these spirits make you aortic samurai. Aortic samurai result like this. So of course, there are high rate of non-elective operation. In hospital mortality, in elective cases, 5.5%. I've lost one patient, but otherwise, patient could survive. So open surgery is the best solution. So this is the Crawford Extend 1, 2, 3 repair in Hong Kong. So conclusion, aortic samurai spirit can be applied to the different environment. Sharing this spirit will bring much better results to us. Disease has no hope. Thinking how to do our best is the most important anytime. Thank you for your attention. Thank you
very much, great epic samurai. Do you have any questions? Please send me. Thank you for.
About the intercostal artery implantation. You routinely implant in C9, C12, or in the patient intercostal artery?
So you mean whether we reconstruct intercostal artery routinely or not? In Crawford Extend to repair, we usually reconstruct. But in descending aortic replacement, we usually don't reconstruct intercostal.
How many that you
need? Oh, one pair.
Only one.
Generally one pair. And basically, a big hole, a big osteo, but less backflow. So we don't check SCP or MEP. And before surgery, we can check CT scan. And, because we noticed Adam Cubitt's artery, but not so much concern about Adam Cubitt's artery.
So you should buy the CT scan, or you look in the operating room. In the muscle, the pair that you will look reconstruction.
Yes.
How do you select that? How do you know that you should be implant this pair?
So your question is that how. Can I choose?
Yeah.
Just if open up air, there are a lot of backflow. But during when we see the intercostal artery osteo, there are some intercostal artery have big osteo but less backflow. So in such case, that hole maybe less blood supply. Otherwise, if the other intercostal artery has a good backflow, it supplied to from the other person. So I think Dr. Kayamoto told us so be cold and less dark.
Thank you, Vinosh. Thank you for a great presentation.